episode 1659, Are You Too Helpful?
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. It is the weekend, and I hope you're enjoying some family time. I know I am. In fact, we are getting ready for school. Yes, it is around the corner, but we're not going to talk about that. It's Relationship Builders Day. It's how to build a strong marriage, that foundation. But the question is, are you too helpful? For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already even had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, do you feel like you're always doing everything for everybody, trying to make things better? Are you too helpful? In fact, you might be addicted to helpfulness, the nurture side of you constantly engaging. Now, helping is a great asset, right? You know, it's a positive trait and nothing you should be ashamed of. When you help someone, we want to help. We want to reach out. However, where does personal growth happen if you're always giving the answers? Plus, who is to say you have the right answers? Now, I know already you're sitting here going, Christiane, really? I mean, come on. Maybe you're running and you're starting to run faster because this is kind of getting under your skin. Am I too helpful? How can I be too helpful? Isn't that what I'm supposed to do in my marriage? Well, in marriage or any committed relationship, it's convenient to want to take care of your sweetheart, right? Especially during dating, right? You were very helpful in every manner. You wanted to learn more about your incredible man, your incredible woman that you found. And you wanted to care for their every need, even if it was just to go run downstairs, like if you were dating in college, run downstairs and get him a soda out of the vending machine and come back up because he was studying for an exam. You care for him and you want to extend that by even doing, actually physically taking care of things. Please know, though, that there is a difference in serving and going overboard on helpfulness. You can actually be over helping and not even know it. Yes, I've been there, I've done that. And I never saw it as a negative. And I'm not saying that it is. Understand that this is just really some food for thought today. Because we're coming up on a new season. We've got fall approaching. I mean, right now down south, we've got some heat wave happening. And I'm looking forward to a little bit of fall weather. I would like some crispiness in the air. But for now, we've got this heat. So in preparation for the season to come, I really want to give you some food for thought. Are you too helpful? You can't take care of everybody all the time. And I was like that. I was doing everything. I was everything for my children. I was everything for what I did in the church, for my praise kids. I was everything for my husband. At least that's how I saw all of those areas. Anything I volunteered for, anything I did and dived into, I put my all in all. I was extra helpful. Now, in my mind, I wasn't saying that. It was just like, this is how I was raised. You need something done, you jump in, you say, yes, I can do it. Somebody asks you to do something, sure, I can do it. Everything's a yes, 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 yes. There's no no's. Well, before we moved down south, my husband had to move first because we had to sell our home up north. Well, this had been the longest time we had been apart since college and his residency and training. I wasn't really sure how he was going to handle it, let alone how I was going to handle it. Would he be able to eat? What would he eat since I cook for him all the time? Who would run his errands and go shopping for him? Who would take care of the bills? I paid the bills. Who would run to the post office or go grocery shopping? Who would do all of this? Well, guess what? He did it, and he did it beautifully. He survived 6 months without me. Go figure. It shocked him too, I know. It made me realize, though, that he can do a lot for himself. Now, I know he's a very capable man. I have no doubt in that. But you have to understand one thing. We put ourselves in positions within our relationships. We position ourselves. And honestly, sometimes it's to maybe create a safe zone for ourselves. It allows us to feel comfortable with where we are. And so when I really began to realize that, hey, he can do this, I was like, this is awesome. Maybe then when I move down there, I don't have to do everything. Maybe he can run some errands. Maybe he can go to the big box store sometimes and I don't always have to be the only one who goes. I kind of began to like that idea. How cool would that be? I don't have to do all the grocery shopping. I don't mind doing it because of how our family situation and our dynamics are set up. I have no problem with that. But if I need him to run and grab a few things right after work and I can stay home instead of me going out and taking more time, etc., that's fantastic. Now understand, we all have different roles in our marriages, and it's important to know which role you fill. And also you have to think about that there are seasons in your marriage. There are going to be seasons where you may have to do everything. You may have a season in your life where your spouse becomes ill or there's an accident. Something happens that's unusual and you have to be there to care, to help. Okay, that's a season. That's different. We're talking about day-to-day, everyday type of habits that we do that we really don't realize that we're doing. And then there may be seasons where we have to serve differently. Maybe your spouse is changing jobs. You may have to do a few things differently during a period of time to make adjustments, right? We had to make that adjustments. When he moved down south, we were still up north. We made those adjustments. We had two different households, but we got through it. The key, though, is knowing if you are serving versus controlling. Now, think about it. Being too helpful keeps you what? In control. When you're overly helpful, it's like, oh, I got this. And if you've got it, that means you're in control. And I know as moms, we're always in control. We do the shopping. We do, most of us, do the cooking. You know, most of us do the laundry. Most of us do the cleaning. We take care of everything. We tell the kids when to go to bed, when to get up, when to take a nap, when to pick up their toys, right? We are the control freak, so to speak. And so sometimes we don't necessarily mean to look at it this way, and I don't think we do. But I came across this and I was like, oh my gosh, I do think at times that I was too helpful, not just with my spouse, but with my children, with my friends, with my family. So maybe you're being helpful, but the helpfulness is really coming out of control. Yet you see it as just helping out because you were raised that way. There's nothing wrong with being raised in serving, right? But it's when we over exaggerate the serving part where we're always helping, we seem to have it all under control. So if you find yourself doing absolutely everything, take a closer look as to your role in the marriage. Are you trying to control or are you really serving? Which is it? Now, I want to make sure that you understand this. When you serve and when you're in control, you have to determine what that definition is. Your dynamics in your marriage is going to be totally different than my marriage. And so I can't sit here and say, well, if you're doing this, 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 and this, that means you're a control freak. I can't tell you that. What I can do is I can help you walk through some things. You can share with me what your day-to-day looks like. And then we can begin to break things down. And if you're like, well, I really don't know where I fit in this, maybe I am a control freak. I was. I was very much a control freak, but I did not look at myself that way. I was just being a really good steward, I thought. I was being helpful to my husband. I was helping the community. I was helping the church. I was serving the kiddos. I was taking care of the world. I was Wonder Woman. Why not? Why not me? Because I was in control. But you see, there is a difference. Are you too helpful? Well, regardless if you think you are serving or being too helpful, one way that will ground you and create a strong foundation in your marriage is starting with a simple question. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Start with a simple question. Now, you're not expected to have all the answers in your marriage. You're not expected to do everything for everybody in the family. Yet, if you're honest, you've already taken upon that role. And if you weren't granted that, you just said, that's mine, that's my baby. You set the boundaries and the expectations for how you want to be treated and the role you play. You see, most of us don't ask our spouse, well, what role do I play in our marriage? What role am I supposed to do? What is my job description? Have you ever sat down with your spouse and said, what's my job description? I can tell you I've never done that with my hubby. Never. And I don't know that I ever will. Now, since we have gone through some ups and downs, we've come through our tornado, we're out on the other side, we do specify a little bit differently. So our communication is much clearer. And there's clarity as to what he will do for me and what I will do for him. And as each day arises, we do different things at different times. There's no set that this happens. Now, there might be a few things. I tend to do the dishes. Why? Because I'm home. That doesn't mean I have to do them, but I am home. My children have activities. I'm home. I can do that. Do they know how to do the dishes? Of course they do. They can do the dishes, and they do the dishes. But I'm one who does the dishes. But guess what? They do their laundry. Yeah, they do their laundry. I don't have to do it. My husband does his laundry. Now, do I do his laundry also? Yes, I do. Does he do my laundry once in a while? Yes, he does. But as a whole, most of the time, he's doing his and I'm doing mine. It just works with us. But that doesn't mean that on certain times, I'm not washing his clothes and he's not washing my clothes. But very rarely do we find spouses who will come together and say, what's my job description? What is the role that I play in this marriage? We don't ask that question. So in order to allow you to continue to serve, but not be too helpful or come in the confines of controlling, start with a simple question. How can I help you? It's five words. How can I help you? Because if you don't ask this simple question, it's easy to be what? Overhelpful. And when you feel like you're doing everything for everybody, what happens over time? Resentment builds. And it begins to cripple your spouse's ability to solve his own problems or even grow personally. And I know most of us don't ever get to that part of it. We don't get to the part of going, oh my gosh, me resenting my spouse? Surely not. I mean, I'm serving. But how many times have you found yourself taking out the trash or doing the laundry or doing the dishes or picking up toys or putting down the toilet seat, whatever it is, running errands, and you mumble to yourself, why do I have to do everything? It's always me doing everything. I'm telling you right now, that's a red flag for resentment, which builds what? Bitterness over time. That is a red flag, as in, oh my goodness, watch out, because your foundation is beginning to crack. But when you take that moment and you ask, how can I help you? You open up a line of communication as to what is needed in that moment. And it gives your spouse the opportunity to what? Respond, not to react, not for you to feel like, oh my gosh, I have to do this again. No, you don't have to. You asked. You see, I do this with my husband. Yes, on a daily basis. I ask him, hey, what can I do for you today? How can I serve you? How can I help you? I word it differently. It just depends on what we're talking about in conversation. And guess what? He does the same for me. Sometimes I'll get a quick phone call before he comes home. He's like, I'm on my way home. Is there anything I can do for you? Do you know how amazing that feels? When you're sitting here trying to take care of 5 children, run the household, get dinner ready, and you got your hubby who sends you a text that says, what can I do for you? It's freeing. It allows you what? To put a smile on your face. And joy fills your heart. A simple question, how can I help you? Also, when you ask that question, you're removing what from the equation? Control. You're no longer trying to control your spouse, nor the situation. You're simply saying, I'm here. How can I help you? How can I serve you today? What is it that you need done that I can help you with? And maybe there'll be days that he's like, oh, nothing. I got it, babe. Thanks for asking. And there may be other days that you get a list of 10 things and you're like, oh, I only asked this because I really only wanted one thing. You haven't seen my calendar. Okay, yeah, maybe then you're going to be like, okay. Then you start saying, I can only get these 3 things done, hun. So, you know, is that the priority? Communication. A question. A simple question. Don't get in the habit of doing everything for everybody. Don't carry that weight on your shoulders, because when you do that, it puts a weight where? On your heart. And if you're not careful, that heart begins to hurt and it gets injured. And that's when the foundation begins to crack. Reset those boundaries and ask the simple question, how can I help you? Go out today, be present in your marriage. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.